Okay, class, good afternoon. Can you hear me?
Can.
Okay, thank you, Wei Xiang. And then number two, like usual, can you see my presentation? Can you see my screen sharing?
Can.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Wei Xiang, thank you very much for your response. Very good. So how many student right now to alpha 20, only 20. Okay, never mind. Okay, class. So we can start now, right? Okay, if you can see my screen sharing, my presentation. So I need you to do this, individual. So I think before we can finish this assignment, before school reopening on 5th of April, right? So you can refer to your textbook, page 56, right? Page 56, activity 3.3. I need you to send this assignment after the school reopen on next month. Okay, so we have about 3 weeks for you to finish the finish this assignment. Okay, so this is the first one, activity 3.3. You can refer to the screen, or you can open to page 56 your textbook to see what assignment I need you to do in these 3 weeks. Yeah, so start from activity 3.3. The aim or the title for this assignment is to collect information on calorific value of food. Okay, instruction number one, so work in group. Okay, but never mind, and I need you to send this assignment individually. Okay, individually. All right. So what I need you to do, okay, each of you, you need to collect, okay, you need to collect about 2 food labels. Okay, 2 food labels that show the food calorific value. Any type of food is permitted. Any type of food is permitted. Eh? So, I think for only food, only 2 food label is very, very little. Eh? So, I need you to, I want to change you, not, I want you to find 4 food label. Okay, any type of food, okay. If you find, you can find the nutrition facts, you find the food label at the back of the food packaging. Okay, I want you to cut it out, okay, properly, and then you can stick it inside your exercise book. Okay, can you understand me? Any type of food that contain nutrition facts, all right? That contain nutrition facts, any type of food, whether it is biscuit, okay, instant noodles or drinks or whatever, okay? Each of you need to find 4 food labels. 4 food labels, you cut it out. Okay, and then you paste it into your exercise book. Number one. Okay, this is individually, not in groups. Okay, because I think that is very, very easy assignment. Okay, you no need to form a group. Later on, if I have others assignment for you, okay, maybe I will arrange it in group. But activity 3.3, page 56 on your textbook, This is an individual assignment. Right? Individual assignment. Okay. So next one, number three. All right. You must fill in the calorific value of food found on the food label like one below. These are the example. Okay. For example, this one, canned food. You also can give the name lah. For example, the Milo drink. You just write here at the section, at the food section here, you can write Milo drinks, for example. Okay, or Pringles or Twisties or whatever food you able to find. And then second column divided by three classes of food, whether it is carbohydrate, protein or fat, and then what is the amount of energy, amount of energy in 100 gram, okay, in 100 gram, and then what is the calorific value, what is the calorific value of the three classes of food. All right, so this is number one, food number one, and then food number two. How many food I how many calorific value in food I need you to find? How many? How many class?
Four.
Four, you need to find four calorific value. So you need to find four food labels, and then you try to find the calorific value of each class of food, mainly carbohydrate, protein, and fat. Okay, and then number four. Okay, you discuss the following things. Okay, you just answer the question here. Which food has the lowest and highest calorific value? Okay, you analyze the data or the value you gain from the four food label. And then you just do a quick analysis which one has the highest and lowest calorific value. Okay. And then B, 4B, what are the nutrients are printed on the food labels? Okay. You try to find another, what we call, another four, whether it has minerals. You just write it down, list it down, whether it has mineral, vitamin, minerals, vitamin, fiber or water, but usually maybe vitamin and minerals lah, if there is any. Okay, if there is any. Can you understand this? Can you understand how to do this? You just do it on your exercise book. Okay. Any type of food lah, yeah. You maybe want to find food packaging in a plastic because easier for you to cut, easier for you to cut the what we call the food labeling, the nutrition facts here. Easier for you to cut it, and then you can paste it. Okay, you can stick it inside your exercise book. Okay. Is it okay?
Okay.
Okay, good. All right. The deadline for this assignment, activity 3.3 assignment, deadline you must pass up, turn it in to me after the school reopen. Okay. On 5th of maybe the first week lah, the first week on April, the first week on April 2021, you pass up it to me. In fact, actually, you must try to pass up all the exercise book, and then all the exercise actually at the first and the second week of April, actually, but never mind. So I give you 3 weeks, about 3 weeks from now to do the assignment here. Okay. If you have any question, like you told, you can ask on our Telegram group lah, yeah. Okay, very good. How about others? No problem, Heng Tong. Okay, very good. Very hot. Okay. All right. So, next one, planning a balanced diet. Okay, planning a balanced diet. We already talked about balanced diet. What is balanced diet? A balanced diet meaning that the food, okay, the food or the menu that has all 7 classes of food in a right quantity. Okay, you still remember the classes of food? Okay, so the balanced diet mean the diet or the food that contain all 7 classes of food, not just contain all 7 type of classes of food, but also in right amount. Okay, and then we also learn about the factor. The factor of calorific requirement, okay, size of body, age, work, gender, health condition, and climate. We also already learned about this. The calorific requirement, the factor that affecting the nutrient or the calorific requirement. Ini pun kita sudah belajar, right? Okay. So, why we need to plan a balanced diet? Okay. Only one ultimate purpose, okay? Because we want ourselves to remain active and healthy at the same time. Okay? Because mainly, most of the current disease right now is related to diet. And then related to our living style. Okay, for example, junk food, the things that we eat will affecting our life. Okay, so that's why we need to plan a balanced diet. Right? You still remember the picture I show you? Okay, the portion of the food inside one plate. Because Malaysian usually, we still remember our last class. I will show you the picture. I will show you the picture that usually Malaysian eat maybe more than half portion of the plate. Okay, just full of rice. Only a little vegetables, only a little fruits. But mostly half, more than half, maybe more than half portion of the plate contain rice. More carbohydrate, okay, but less vegetable and less food. That is not the what we call the guide lah. The correct portion is not like that. What's the correct portion? You still remember? Quarter and what? Anybody? Quarter.
Half.
Yes, Ying Tong. Thank you. Quarter. If you have one plate, one plate, meaning that you have quarter, half, meaning quarter of rice. Okay, you maybe have only quarter of protein, meat, of fried chicken or fish, and then half of the portion. Okay, half of the plate, you must eat what we call vegetables and fruits. That is the what we call the recommended diet or the recommended menu for what we call a balanced diet for healthy living. Okay, you must remember that. And then also you must also remember the food pyramid. Which type of food you can take more, and then which type of food you must take less. For example, sugar, salt, you must take less. Okay, but you can take plenty of food in what category? In carbohydrate category, lah. For example, the bread. Okay, you can eat. You know, maybe slightly more than salt and sugar, right? Okay. Activity 3.4. Later on, I will give you the complete guide because I think you need to do this activity as well. Okay, to plan a balanced diet. Excuse me. To plan a balanced meal for a day based on different factor. Okay, I will give you the complete guide before I give you this assignment. Yeah, 3.4. Okay. Also in individual later on the day, I will give you the total, what we call the how you want to do this assignment, yeah, 3.4. Okay, this one later on. Okay, and then the last subtopic for 3.1, yeah, the importance of maintaining health. So you can read it for yourself. Okay, this is just what we call an extra information. Okay, inside the textbook, it said that the percentage of Malaysian with diabetes is 17.5%, high blood pressure is 30%, high cholesterol is 47%. Okay, obesity 70% and overweight is 40%. So this is the problem, the disease that related to improper diet, okay, or unbalanced diet, okay. And then the figure here is increasing by year. That's why we need to give people advice and awareness, okay, because we need to do a balanced diet, not just a balanced diet, but also we must have a proper lifestyle. For example, you must do exercise 3 times a week, and then not only exercise, not only on diet, but you also need to, you know, to have your mind also healthy. Okay, healthy mind. Okay, keep calm and try to not to be stressful. Okay, for example, teachers also have their stress level. Student like you also have the stress level. Maybe you think so many work to do, so many homework, so many exercise to do, so many subject. But try to keep it calm, okay, and then you try to do your best. Try to do try to do your best, huh? Just relax. Eh? It is not what we call end of the world. Okay, right. So activity 3.5. Maybe we can start after the school reopen. So the rest of the article here, I think you can read it for yourself because it nothing fancy about it. Eh? Just read it. Okay, what is the importance of the what we call a balanced diet and whatever. Okay. And then this one, body mass index. I think we already do this in PJK as well. And the activity 3.6 also, I think we wait for the school reopen. I will give you the guide on how to do the assignment. Okay. Any question? Okay, how about formative practice 3.2? I asked you to do this or not yet? 3.2. Because I think I haven't asked you to do this exercise. 2 alpha. Last exercise is on your workbook, page 28. So we already finished 3.1. So I need you, okay, today, your exercise for today is formative practice 3.3.2. Okay? Is it okay?
Okay.
The line is clear. Internet is okay, right? You can hear me, huh? You can see my presentation as also, huh?
Can.
Okay, how about the rest of you? How many students right now? 26. Wow, okay lah. Ramai juga. 36, not 26. 24, 25. Okay, very good, very good. Nearly full class. Right. So any question before we start the new subtopic for today?
No.
No, huh? Okay, never mind. So we'll start. Maybe I'll take another 20 or 15 minutes. Okay, we start next subtopic for today, 3.3, Human Digestive System. Okay, you still remember what is the meaning of system? You still remember what is system? System, meaning that if in form one, system is what? It's the combination of what? Can you still remember what is system? If you still remember in Form 1, Chapter 2, the cell organization, okay? You start from cell. And then after cell, anybody? We start from cell, and then after cell? Anybody? Form 1, cell organization. We start from
start
cell.
From cell.
And then into? After cell?
Tissue.
Cannot hear lah.
Tissue.
Okay. Cell and then tissue. One mantai, very good. Thank you. Cell and then tissue. And then after tissue will become?
Organ.
Organ, yes. And then after organ?
System.
After organ will become system. And then system will become?
Organism.
Organism, okay. Meaning that tissue is a group. Tissue is the group of same cell, okay. And then organ is the what we call the group of what? Organ is the group of tissue, and then after organ is what? Is system, okay? System is a group of organ, and then organism. So in form one, we already learn, you already learn in form one, what type of system? Form one? In form one, you already learn what type of system? Who still remember? System in human, yeah? System in human. Okay, never mind. If you still remember in Form 1, you already learned reproductive system. System chapter 4. If you still remember chapter 4, reproductive system. Okay, in chapter 4, Form 1. So, Form 2, you learn another system. We call it a human digestive system. Okay? In Form 2, you learn one what we call another system in human. We call it human digestive system. Okay. Form 1, human reproductive system. Form 2, human digestive system. Okay. Very easy this one. You need to know what is food digestion. Okay, what's the mean by food digestion? Okay, what happened here? Food digestion. Okay, food digestion here. Meaning that is the process of breaking down food that is complex and large into molecules that are small, simple, and soluble so that they can be absorbed by the cell of the body. Okay, this is what we call by the definition of food digestion. Okay, why? Because our food, the food that we eat is not processed yet. Okay, the food that we eat cannot be absorbed directly to our body. It need to be digest. It need to be break down. It need to be what we call break down into simple substance. Can you understand this? That's why we need to have digestive system. Digestion here mean the process of breaking down the food that is complex. Complex mean not simple lah. Large, what we call a complex substance, we need to break it down into a simpler molecule or the simpler substance that is small, simple and soluble so that our body can absorb it easily. And that's why we need to learn human digestive system. Okay, the food need to be processed in order for our body to absorb it. We cannot directly absorb the food from outer sources. Okay, can you understand this? Boleh faham ini? We need to have a process. We need to process the food first. Any kind of food. Because human got many type of food, you know. Sometimes many type of people, many type of race, many type of country have many type of food. Malay have its own special food. Chinese also it has its own special food, you know. Malay with it nasi lemak lah, kan? If you have what we call kedai mamak, you go to kedai mamak and then you have roti canai. And then Chinese, maybe you have your own type of food. There are so many type of food, okay? But each of that food need to be processed so that we can what we call absorb its nutrient. Okay, for example, carbohydrate, right? You already learn about carbohydrate, protein, and then what, fat, okay? We need to, in order to get that 7 classes of food, it need to be break down first. Okay, can you understand this? Boleh faham, eh? Okay, next one. Digestion. We have two type of digestion. One is physical, and then one is chemical. Okay, we have two type of digestion, physical and chemical. Okay, you must understand the meaning of digestion. Break down the food from complex to simpler one so that able to absorb by the body. All right, so we have two type of digestion. One is physical, one is chemical. So what is physical? Physical break down also the food. Why cannot highlight it anymore? I cannot highlight it. Underline. Cannot highlight, never mind. Okay, physical. The process of breaking down the food into smaller particles in the mouth with the help of teeth, tongue, and saliva. Physical. The first step in the food digestion, when you put the food into your mouth, what your mouth will do? You chew it. Okay, big portion, for example, big portion of bread, for example. Okay, you put on your mouth and then you start to chew it. Why? Because we want to make the big, we want to convert it into smaller particle. Bagi dia kecil potong. By using what? By using the teeth, the sharp, what we call sharp characteristic of the teeth, and then with the help of the tongue and also saliva. That's what we call by physical. And then it involves peristalsis. Later on, we go, what is peristalsis? And then the second type of digestion is, we call it physical. The first is physical. The second is chemical. Sorry, the second type of digestion is chemical. So still the same process. What is the process? We want to break down the food. Okay, but in chemical, from complex molecule into a simple molecule with the help of enzyme. Okay, what is enzyme? Enzyme is the substance in the body that speed up the chemical digestion. Okay, but for example, when we have physical inside the mouth, we also have physical and then chemical digestion. Okay, physical by using our physical body such as tongue and teeth, because we want to bite, we want to chew the food. And then chemical, there is an enzyme inside the saliva that may that convert the what we call the complex substance of the food into the simpler one. Okay, next one. So what's the difference and the similarity between physical and chemical digestion? The similarity, physical and chemical, break down the food and then happen in the digestive tract. Huh? Digestive tract, what is digestive tract? The place lah, the place where the food break down. The where we break down the food inside the body. So this is the what we call the similarity. And then what is the difference? Physical in mouth. And then does not involve enzyme. Enzyme, what is enzyme? Enzyme is just like a chemical, a special chemical that break down the food. Okay? Whereas the chemical digestion happen in mouth also, in stomach, duodenum, and intestine. There are four organs, okay, inside the intestine digestive tract that undergo chemical digestion. And then it involve enzyme. Okay, enzyme just a chemical. Enzyme is just a chemical. When you put inside the food, it will break down the food without using physical digestion. Okay, that is what we call by enzyme. Okay, can you understand? Setakat ini okay, boleh faham? What is digestion? Number one, what is digestion? And then type of digestion. One is physical and one is chemical. And then please identify the similarity and the difference between physical and chemical digestion. Okay? So next one. Okay, next one, the structure of human digestive system. The structure of human digestive system, yeah, human digestive system. Okay, like usual, if you're learning about a system, you must able to identify the parts and the function of the system. Identify the organ, identify the parts and function of the system. Okay, you can also refer to page 61 on your textbook. Okay, so this is the parts and function of human digestive system. If you can look here, there are multiple of organ, right? Many organ working together to form a system. Okay, we go one by one. Okay, first one is mouth. This is the mouth. Okay, and then we have salivary gland. Salivary gland here is the place. Okay, it's the place or the location inside the body that secretes saliva. Bahagian yang mengeluarkan air liur, because inside mouth we have always what we call wet, right? Always has moisture inside the inside the mouth. Okay, we call it saliva. Okay, we call it saliva. So this is salivary gland. And then number three, esophagus. Number three, esophagus, just a long tube connecting the mouth to the stomach. This is esophagus. Okay, number four, we have stomach. Okay, number five, we have duodenum. Yeah, number six, we have small intestine. Okay, large intestine. Number seven, number eight, we have pancreas. Number nine, we have gallbladder. Number 10, we have liver. Number 11, we have rectum. And 12, anus. Okay, these are the 12 parts or 12 organ inside our digestive system. Okay, these parts and function you must try to remember. And then the next picture beside it on your right is the flow of food. If the flow of food, okay, when you first put your food inside the mouth, where the food goes? First, it will go through mouth and then go to esophagus and then go to stomach and then goes to duodenum and then goes to small intestine, and then the food goes to large intestine, rectum, and then the last organ the food will go is through anus. Okay, this is what we call the flow of the food particle. All right, can you understand this? Okay, you just need to remember the parts and then their function of organ in our digestive system. Okay, is it okay? Boleh ingat?
Okay.
Okay, never mind. Okay, is it actually it's very what we call, if you understand it, it quite simple. Yeah, but sometimes don't worry. But sometimes maybe you we also tend to forget. But never mind. Yeah, we try to learn it. Yeah, slowly. Yeah, one by one. Okay. Next one. I think I will wait. So what is the okay, the flow of food, next one, the flow of food in the digestive tract, right? So I think I will continue. I will not to continue. I think I will stop here because I want to do the simplest explanation. Because inside the textbook is quite complex explanation. I just want to do the simpler one. Okay, never mind. I will continue with the flow of food in digestive tract next class. So I will stop here until what? Until the parts and function of digestive system only. Okay, this topic, the flow of food in the digestive tract, I will continue to our next class. Is it okay? Boleh, saya akan sambung ini kelas yang seterusnya. I will continue this topic next class. Because I cannot use the textbook because the textbook a bit complex. I want to just highlight the important facts only. Is it okay?
Okay.
One is now is 1:15. So I will continue this topic next class, which is on, I think your next class is on tomorrow. Tomorrow. Okay. We have class tomorrow, Wednesday, 9 to 10 a.m. And then next class is on Thursday. Okay. If I have any changes on the timetable, I will inform you later. Yeah, but I think class for tomorrow is on schedule lah. Yeah, class for tomorrow is on time. Okay. So, what I need to you to do the exercise, I will give the instruction on your exercise for today on our Telegram group. Okay, I will give the exercise on our Telegram group.
Okay. Is that okay?
Okay. Okay. Very good. So, thank you very much for your attention. So, we end our online class for today. So, we continue tomorrow on Wednesday. Okay? Thank you very much. You can leave the class right now. Okay?
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.